It is 7 away from 8. Well, Shane Cameron's career has been given new life after many wrote it off when he lost to David Tua in that heavyweight title fight about 3 years back. He dropped a division and has fought his way back to face another title fight, this time the cruiserweight title against Danny Green, which will take place next month. And Shane Cameron is with us. Good morning to you.
Good morning.
You're looking in very fine shape. You're set to go?
Thank you. Yeah. I will be come 21st of November next month, so we got just over 4 weeks to go. Training's going awesome. You know, as you pointed out, I've got to drop the weight because my last fight against Barrett, I was a heavyweight. So this one here, I've got to drop about a good part of 7 kilos. So
7?
Yeah.
In 4 weeks?
No. I've dropped 3 kilos already. So,
oh, that's okay. Four to go.
Yeah.
How do you drop it? What do you do?
I've just got a very good diet. Very good diet in place. Sort of 2,600 calories a day, which is not a lot for a guy doing a lot of work.
I was going to say, what's that involved? What are you going to eat today?
I've already had one meal this morning, which is my porridge, which is about 450 calories. So I'm just balancing that, having that amount of calories per meal, 6 meals a day, and just keeping strict with it. You know, keeping strict with it, which equals me losing the weight and equals making sure I still got the right energy, so I can consist a good training.
Is it hard yards? It sounds horrific. I mean, for a start, porridge. Bleh.
Well, it's my job, mate. So it's not too hard for 7 weeks leading into the biggest fight of my career. So there's sort of nothing really to ask for the result that I want to get.
I was looking at a photo of you and Danny Green this morning. You're taller than he is.
Yeah, there's a bit of height there on my side. There will be a bit of weight too because I don't actually know what he weighs, but he's sort of more of a blown up light heavy as opposed to a genuine cruiser. Whereas I'm more of a heavy and coming down to make cruiser.
Yeah, that's good. And you can go back to heavy? Do you see yourself going back to heavy at any time?
Definitely. I still like the heavyweight division. I had a good win over Barrett. It was a good weight for me at 97 kilos. So that's my natural body weight. Now, I won't be the biggest heavyweight in the world, by all means, but I'm certainly comfortable at that weight.
So what's the plan? So you beat Danny Green, so you get the cruiserweight title, so that's you, so world champ, it's all good.
I like the way you're thinking, mate.
Yeah, exactly. I can give you some motivation, no worries. So what happens after that?
Well, we're in a position of strength, and then you know, if you're in a position of strength and you're in the driving seat, well, that opens a lot of doors for me, whether that be at cruiserweight or whether that be at heavyweight. So as I said, I'm not counting the heavyweight division, so if something shiny comes up in heavyweight division, I'll go back there.
Heavyweight division seems tarnished at the moment a bit, doesn't it? The action seems in the cruiserweight area. There's some genuine good-looking athletes at cruiserweight. The heavyweights are full of, you know, apart from your Klitschko boys, it's full of, you know, thugs and buffoons and half-wits and deadbeats.
Certainly the heavyweight division is dominated by the Klitschko brothers. They own all the belts. The cruiserweights is a lot more balanced through throughout the world, really, in terms of champions. I'm just lucky that I can make. Not a lot of heavyweights can make the two divisions, you know, without too much struggle. So I'll just take the best opportunity, and most importantly for me is to make sure that I pick up that title 21st November.
Has it been tough to fight back or come back from the tour thing, that whole, well, you're not as good as we thought you were routine?
Yeah, definitely. You know, I had to swallow that for 3 years, and within that 3 years I dropped the weight and won the Commonwealth title that no one had won in 36 years in New Zealand, but that was sort of overshadowed by the loss to David, and then having the opportunity to fight Monty Barrett, and that was one of the easiest fights of my life, you know, of my career, actually, fighting Monty Barrett. Just fought smart, and styles make fights, and it was an easy night.
You flattened him. Well, I'm sure you got another meal. You got 5 more of them to go, and you got some training to do. Thanks for popping in. I appreciate it very much, and all the very best for next month.
Thanks very much.
Good to see you.